Morning team, Macho Models. It is December and I'm about to start a new process, a new application that I've never tried before, and that is of course black basing. So for a lot of the aircraft modelers or people that are kind of well-versed in the hobby, this is probably an old hat to you. However, you know, there's a big Gundam contingency that I support and that I follow, and I'm really looking forward to trying this on the X-29 and then taking it over into my Gundam work later on. So just really quickly about black basing, and I'll also put a couple links in the description of this video to people that are far more qualified than me to talk about this. But the real kind of quick how and why of why I'm pursuing black basing is that if you look across the spectrum of real life versus models, the pre-shading technique that we kind of either attract to or glom onto does not exist. I'm sorry. If you find an instance of where pre-shading in real life is reflective, please send it to me, because I have not, from kind of my experience, seen it really exist. I think it's more of an artistic presentation, and from an artistic standpoint, pre-shading is perfectly fine. Like, if it's attractive to you and you like it, great. However, I don't think it is the most realistic representation in real life. So what a lot of the model community does, if they're really going for that kind of one-to-one realistic representation, is they do black basing. And the concept here with black basing, and I'll try to capture as much of this in execution as possible, is that you throw down a black base, even if it's on a white model, and what you're gonna see as I kind of go through this build is that I'm gonna start kind of putting this like speckled camo-ish pattern. And again, look at other videos about this. Don't take simply my work for, you know, at face value. Before I started on this X-29 project, I probably watched like half a dozen videos of people talking about black basing and have the concept down. So this should hopefully just be a launching point for you if you're curious about black basing. But again, kind of an execution, what you're going to see is that I'm going to start kind of putting down these like spotted sections, and then I'm going to do it with a couple different tones. So I'm going to try at first with a lighter gray tone, and then I'm going to work to mix in a tan, and then maybe even like a green or a sky blue. Once I have all of that accomplished, that's when I'll come over with my paint. And the effect that I'm trying to go for is, you know, if you're looking at these panels in real life, they're not drawn out with like a, you know, a deep shade. Like, that would denote that there's like a certain depth to it. They're actually, you know, if you look at it in real life, you'll notice a certain inconsistency in paint. Now, the X-29 is meant to be like a test aircraft, and for Area 88 Shin Kazama, it was like a combat aircraft, right? So I'm trying to kind of strike a happy balance between the real life example and the anime example. So I think black basing should be a really good way to kind of convey, okay, that this aircraft has been used in combat, and yes, it did come from a test platform. But I'll stop talking now, and I'm going to attempt to film me while shooting my airbrush, and we'll see if I can go ahead and throw some helpful or clever narration over top of it. Okay, so I'm set up and I'm about to start spraying and putting my first layer down for my black basing. So I went through my colors and I picked three that will serve as my my base for my black base. And what you want to do, and again, I'm going to link to a video where somebody a bit more qualified than me is going to talk to this, is that per your base, your black color, and then whatever your final color is, you wanna pick tones, excuse me, that are in between that color. So for instance, black is my blue glove, right? And then I'm gonna spray this with a GSI Creo off-white. So in between there, I need to choose tones that are somewhere in the middle, right? Like, I don't wanna pick really dark grays, and I don't wanna pick really, you know, bright yellows to kinda use in the middle of my black base. I wanna pick something that's a little bit closer in the middle. So the way that I kinda spec that out is I chose XF25 light sea gray. So this is gonna be my color that's a little bit closer towards that black scale. I picked light blue. So this is almost like a grayish blue, and I thought this would be really complimentary, especially with the white, you know, to kind of show like sky and air, et cetera, et cetera. I know, paint woo-woo talk. So this is my kind of like directly in the middle tone. And then I also liked, I used this XF55 deck tan. So this is gonna be my tone that's almost closer towards the white. And so that'll kind of keep me in the spectrum. So I have my darkest tone, my light sea gray mixed here. And par for the course, you know, I use Mr. Color Leveling Thinner And then I use my little graduated cup and my pipette. So this mixture is 4-to-1. So I'm going for something pretty translucent because I want the ability to be able to kind of apply it in layers. Also, I'm not really that familiar with this technique, so it's gonna take me a little bit to get everything kind of spun up and kind of figure out the technique. So the thinner the paint, the more of a chance I have to experiment and play and not worry about, you know, permanently quote unquote screwing something up. The last point, and before I cut back and start showing how this thing goes in application, is I'm using my 0.21. So I'm gonna film how I'm spraying this for a little bit, but the reason that I'm going with this versus my 0.4 is that I do want that precision, and you'll see in the application how this works. So I'm pretty excited. Everything's all mixed up. I'll cut here, and the next one will be me in application. Okay, and we're back. A little bit of narration to go along with that video. So I just got done spraying my XF25, my light sea gray mix 4-to-1. And my initial impressions are, I think I did an okay job. You can see where there's a couple spider webs where I was a little hasty with the spray. So right here and right here. And it's a little tricky with that. So I'm really using super, super light pressure to try to just really control it. And one of the techniques I think I started to kind of employ towards the latter part of the aircraft was to spray on the 1, 2, 3 blocks first to kind of get my rhythm and then come back in here. Another big piece too is you have to be really close. So if you notice when I was spraying, I was, you know, just a couple millimeters, maybe a centimeter away from the aircraft. Over here is when I pulled back a little bit more. And what you're really going for, this is kind of the ideals where you get this nice kind of leopard spots that are going on right here. These are a little bit too big, but you know, again, it's okay because I'm gonna put another two layers of kind of stippling and dot paint on top of this before I even put my white coat over top of it. The other big piece is this is the bottom, so I'm okay experimenting a little bit here because the top is really where I want this to show. So it's okay that I first practiced right here. But overall, it looks cool. It didn't take very long at all. I know it looked tedious, but maybe that was like 3 or 4 minutes, and I can kind of see that this pattern or this patina is really going to look awesome when I'm done doing a couple layers on it and then putting my white over it. I think it's going to really give me that realism and depth that I've always been looking for in my work versus panel line shading, which, you know, as I mentioned earlier, is kind of just a bit of a more artistic interpretation of real life. So this is cool. I will probably cut from here and then come back and I'll show you what it looks like once it's all completed. Okay, and we're back, and the black basing part 2, 3, 4, whatnot is looking good. So as you can tell from my voice, I'm pretty stoked about this. When we last cut, I showed you just what it looked like when I did my initial pass with the gray on the underside. And I was a little worried at first, admittedly. So there was a lot of spots and I wasn't sure how it was all gonna come together. But fortunately, as I kind of pressed through this and got a little bit better with my technique and a little bit more confident, I'm really, really happy with how this looks. And I think it's gonna look awesome once I get the Mr. Color 69 over top of that, which is an off-white. So to kind of walk you through where we left off on the black part. I had just done, you know, my initial spray with the gray, and what worked out really well was by using the gray and kind of sparingly putting dots over it, I was actually able to effectively carry a roadmap through, so that when I used my other two colors, it actually worked out really well and it was pretty simple to follow. So for the second color I used this XF23, which is this light blue, and I know the camera is probably not picking up the subtlety in here, but it's showing through actually pretty well on the aircraft itself. So if you'll look, these are actually the highlights, which I'll show you in just a moment, but these lower areas are a mix of that gray and that light blue, which is almost like a gray. So I went through, and where the black was showing actually covered up with the XF23. And then my last color, which you're seeing a lot of, is the XF55. So that's the deck tan. And that's this highlight area right here. And I know that's punching through really easy on the camera. And I'll go ahead and poke this little dot right here that showed up really, really brightly here. But this looks good. From the videos that I've seen about black basing, supposedly this is exactly where you want to be with your build before you put your top coat over it. So I'm going to probably hang it up after this. This took me maybe about an hour to go through with the three colors. And then I have the canards over here as well that I painted. And it was good. It was definitely a little bit of a learning curve to kind of figure out, you know, how the technique works. It's also a little jarring when you throw down your Tamiya that's heavily mixed and there's a bright spot. You're not necessarily sure how it's going to turn out. But, you know, the magic of these alcohol-based thinners, if you just wait a second or two for it to evaporate off, you get a better picture. And the good news is, since I thin these paints down to, you know, an inch of their life, 4:1, I had a lot of working space to be able to pick off. So this looks great. I'm really happy with this. And when I cut back, you'll be able to see the Mr. Color 69, which is this off-white that I actually picked up at Third Eye today when I was hanging around with my folks. Here it is, part 99 of the X29 build. I should say it's not 99 because there's gonna be like 1,000 more. But the good news is the paint is on and I like the way it looks. I know on the camera that this white is not showing up the best. At least I hope it is. So again, this is the Mr. Color X69 over top of all my black basing work. And I like how it turned out. This was a really, really interesting process. So I mixed the Mr. Color paint about 5:1, and I went over it a number of times with kind of like a mist coat, and then I started to slowly get in on the model. And what I actually ended up doing was kind of doing that same templating process where I started by painting this side and just kind of getting it to where I liked it. And then I would flip things over and then come back to this side to try my best to match it. One of the kind of hard slash like interesting balancing acts when doing a black basing coat is you have to really be patient with it. So once you put your paint on, you're not really looking at a true representation of what it's gonna look like when it's gonna dry. If you wait anywhere from 15 to 30 seconds and then heck, even kind of hit it with a hairdryer, you get a much, much better representation of what it's gonna look like when it gets dried. So, you know, when you're throwing down even your most thin paint on top of this, you get a little nervous that all this like hard work that you did to get the black base set up is gone. But if you kind of step back and wait just a moment for the paint to flash off, you'll get a better picture. And it was good. It was very interesting to paint this way as opposed to panel line shading, which admittedly I've only done a little bit of work on, and I'm not much of a kind of straight painter slash clean build slash Hasegawa modeler. So I enjoyed it. And one of the main pieces here is always step back, right? If you're ever getting kind of nervous or unsure about your work, instead of kind of leaning in with the airbrush, and I have a lot of trouble with this, lean back, you know, take a step back from your work, take a pause, you know, have a sip of coffee, turn your spray booth on, and then come back to the booth before you really start laying into it. It's really easy to kind of get nervous about how things are gonna be and to really push into it. But I like the way it turns out. Again, I'm sorry, I can see on my camera there's some blowouts right here, and white typically doesn't show very well. But I can assure you in person, it looks really neat. There's all the subtle tones of the blue and the highlights are popping up. I actually really like the midtones and the darker colors. I kind of wish I had a little bit more of that. I think one of my maybe principal errors or something I'm going to take forward into my next build is that I need to try to keep my little dots a bit smaller. It's the size of them is kind of popping out a little bit more. Another huge thing that I screwed up, I went back and I saw that I had one of a mold release line, a little seam line right here, and I went to go sand it thinking that the paint I could just cover it up. Nope, I'm gonna have to go back and redo both of the little edge sections right here. But I wanted to come back because I felt like if judges were gonna be looking at anything, like this is one of the first things that they're gonna catch. So that's it for the X29 build for today. I'm pretty happy with my progress. I just got to touch up some areas, but I'm looking forward to keeping after it. And then who knows, maybe at some point I'll put a gloss coat down and get some decals going. Actually, maybe sometime this week. But thanks for following along. Thanks for keeping up. And be sure whatever you guys are getting after, you make it macho.